हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल कॉस्मेटिक लाइन। आफ्टर सो लॉन्ग आई हैड कम विद अनदर टॉपिक विच इज़ कॉल्ड एज यूवी प्रोटेक्शन विद इमुलेंट्स हेल्प रिड्यूस फ्लेयरिंग रोजेसी। इट इज़ अ रिव्यू आर्टिकल बाय डेनियल मार्गाडो कारास्को एंड हिज कलीग्स विद द एमडी विच इज़ पब्लिश्ड इन द जर्नल ऑफ कॉस्मेटिक डर्मेटोलॉजी इन नवम्बर 2021. It is said that patients with rosacea, as you can see the picture of the disease known as rosacea, can experience flare-ups due to a variety of triggers including heat, alcohol, spicy food and exposure to ultraviolet radiation. So, what basically is the rosacea is? Rosacea is a chronic inflammatory disease, skin disorder, which most frequently affects fair-skinned women. So, in detail, we can discuss about this research. Rosacea prevalence can be highly variable, ranging from 1% to greater than 20%. Rosacea is characterized by facial erythema, telangiectasia, erythematous papules, pustules, and flushing, among other manifestations. Patient complained about dry skin, dryness, edema, stinging, itching, and burning sensations, along with embarrassment and impairment of social life. Rosacea can produce a negative impact on quality of life and self-esteem. Pathophysiology of rosacea is not completely understood and involves a complex interaction among genetics, environmental factors, microorganisms, impaired skin barrier, neuronal and vascular dysfunction, and immune system disruption. The exposome can be defined as the totality of environmental exposures in a lifetime, which can induce or modify diverse dermatoses. The role of the exposome in rosacea must be highlighted. UV light, air pollution, tobacco smoking, nutrition, and psychological stress can trigger or worsen rosacea. Although UV exposure is one of the most commonly reported triggers, and UV radiation can play a significant role in the pathogenesis of rosacea, the literature on photoprotection in rosacea is relatively scarce. Furthermore, affected individuals typically react to diverse cosmetics and skincare products with stinging, burning, and worsening of rosacea. While there is a wide range of available sunscreen, it can be difficult for patients and dermatologists to determine which sunscreens will be beneficial. The use of sunscreens containing ingredients with emollient, anti-inflammatory, and vasoregulatory properties could not only ensure the required level of photoprotection, but may also have the potential to mitigate the barrier dysfunction, neutralize facial redness using green pigment as camouflage, and decrease inflammation and vascular dysfunction. In this, we have discussed the etiology of rosacea with emphasis on the role of UV radiation and the exposome, and review the importance of non-pharmacologic strategies with a focus on photoprotection. The review confirmed that several environmental factors such as UV light, diverse microorganisms, air pollution, tobacco smoking, nutrition, and physiological stress have been shown to trigger or worsen rosacea. UV radiation was reported to induce pro-inflammatory, pro-angiogenic, and pro-fibrotic responses and may even initiate rosacea. Now, in results and discussion, we have two parts. First is pathophysiology of rosacea, and second one is non-pharmacologic treatment. So, in first part, in pathophysiology of rosacea, rosacea seems to develop from dysregulation of innate and adaptive immune systems and neurovascular dysfunction, disrupted skin barrier, and genetic predisposition. The exposome can play a significant role in inducing the impaired immune or neurovascular response. In genetic predisposition, the genetic contribution to the development of the disorder is estimated to be 46%. Next one is microorganisms and the gut skin axis. Recent evidence suggests a significant role of the cutaneous and gut microbiome. Small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, Helicobacter pylori infection, presence of beta hemolytic Staphylococcus epidermis, and increased density of Demodex folliculum, among other microorganisms, have been implicated in chronic skin inflammation and in the genesis of rosacea. Third one is impaired skin barrier. The lesional skin of rosacea patients can present lower skin conductivity, lower water content, and higher transepidermal water loss. Impaired barrier function may promote skin bacterial colonization and inflammation. Fourth one is dysregulation of immune response. Activation of the innate immune system leads to the release of pro-inflammatory cytokines and antimicrobial proteins such as cathelicidin. Cathelicidin is then cleaved into its active form, which induces degranulation of mast cells and secretion of multiple pro-inflammatory and pro-angiogenic molecules. Next one is neurovascular dysregulation. Activation of transient receptor potential cation channels leads to the release of vasoregulatory neuropeptide, calcitronin, gene-related peptide, and substance P. The next topic is the exposome. As stated before, the exposome can be defined as the totality of environmental exposure of an individual in a lifetime and how those exposures relate to health. Herein, we will describe the most relevant exposome factors involved in the pathophysiology of rosacea. What is the role of ultraviolet radiation? UV radiation is one of the most frequently reported triggers of rosacea. The tendency of disorder to affect the central face may be influenced by the exposure of convex surface of the face to UV light. Sun-protected areas such as the submental and suborbital areas are usually spared. Lifetime UV radiation exposure has been shown to be significantly associated with the presence of rosacea and is the single most important environmental variable. UV radiation can induce an imbalance between oxidant and antioxidant pathways, such as increased serum peroxide and decreased tissue superoxide dismutase observed in rosacea. UV radiation produces reactive oxygen species, which can induce the release of pro-inflammatory cytokines by fibroblasts and keratinocytes. In summary, UV radiation is implicated in all key aspects of rosacea: skin inflammation, neoangiogenesis, telangiectasia, and fibrosis. Air pollution and smoking can also cause rosacea. The impact of air pollution on skin aging, pigmentation, and cutaneous diseases has been highlighted in recent years. Outdoor air pollutants can be significantly associated with increased severity of symptoms in atopic dermatitis. Traffic exhaust emissions seem to affect both skin barrier function and activation of immune responses. UV light and air pollution can have a synergic detrimental effect on the skin. This combination can induce significant cytotoxic and genotoxic damage. It seems reasonable to advise patients to avoid ambient air pollutants when possible. Nutrition. Regarding the impact of nutrition on rosacea, patients report certain foods as triggers, such as spicy food, fatty food, those containing cinnamaldehyde, such as chocolate, tomatoes, and citrus, alcohol, and hot beverages as triggers. Stress. Mental stress is one of the most frequently reported triggers by rosacea patients. Stress can increase the level of corticosterone hormone and activate the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis. Mental stress can induce a hyperresponsiveness in sympathetic nerve activity in the supraorbital skin of rosacea patients and may cause neurovascular dysregulation and local inflammation. Next one is the heat. Heat is commonly reported as an exacerbating factor in rosacea. Individuals exposed to heat from using a tandoor oven exhibited a significantly high incidence of rosacea that control subjects. In results and discussion, we will see the non-pharmacologic treatments such as cleansers, moisturizers, and photoprotection agents affect the rosacea. In the recent evidence suggests that excessive cleansing can induce rosacea. High frequency of cleansing, that is more than once daily, the usage of foaming cleansers, a high quality of cleansers, long baths, which is greater than 11 minutes, overuse of cleansing tools more than 4 times per week, daily exfoliating activity, or sessions of deep cleansing treatment in beauty salons presented a positive correlation with rosacea. Excessive cleansing may induce mechanical damage and chemical irritation to the stratum corneum and alter the normal cutaneous pH. As general skin care, the use of soap-free gentle facial cleansers no more than once daily must be encouraged. As the skin barrier is already damaged in rosacea, any procedure or ingredient known to disrupt it should be avoided. Products containing ingredients likely to induce irritant or allergic contact dermatitis should not be recommended. Next is moisturizers. Rosacea patients often suffer from dry facial skin, and non-oily moisturizers must be indicated. These products can repair the damaged skin barrier, relieve dry skin, improve skin homeostasis, and may reduce the risk of rosacea onset. Unfortunately, these individuals frequently report worsening of symptoms or heightened cutaneous sensitivity to skincare products and allergic contact dermatitis in identified in 30% to 40% of cases. This is why a skincare regimen should be as simple as possible. Preferring cosmetically pleasing moisturizers without fragrance that have must been developed to minimize the risk of irritant or allergic contact dermatitis. Next one is photoprotection agents. Strict sun protection is the cornerstone of management of rosacea. Daily use of a very high tolerance broad spectrum sunscreen with a minimum SPF of 30% is necessary. Studies comparing the effects of different sunscreens on rosacea are lacking. The selection of the texture of the sunscreen is relevant so as to ensure that the product is easy and gentle to apply and cosmetically acceptable. In facial care of rosacea, hydrophilic formulations such as water-based sunscreens are recommended more than oil-enriched formulation, which can lead to heat accumulation and a worsening of dermatitis. Additives such as emollients or ingredients with anti-inflammatory, skin-calming, or vessel-stabilizing properties should be considered. Facial cosmeceuticals such as extracts of some herbal plants are also recommended, which have anti-inflammatory and antioxidant property and can be useful in the treatment of rosacea and may be added to sunscreen formulations. Cosmetic camouflage can be very important in patients with rosacea. Camouflage therapy can give immediate satisfaction to patients and may reduce the impact of the disease on the quality of life. The use of green pigment as an ingredient in sunscreens can also impact positively on patient appearance. In summary, topical sunscreen must be indicated for all rosacea patients. Deciding which, however, among the vast range of products can be challenging. Products with broadband UV protection, water-based sunscreen, easy to remove and containing ingredients with emollient, anti-inflammatory, antioxidant and vasoregulatory properties should be preferred. The use of tinted sunscreen or those containing green pigment for camouflage could be considered and discussed with the patient. In conclusion, we can say that the exposome can negatively impact on rosacea patients. Avoidance and protection from non-triggers such as environmental and emotional stimuli and certain food should be recommended. Among these factors, UV radiation is crucial in the pathogenesis of rosacea. The appropriate skincare, use of moisturizers, and adequately formulated sunscreen are the cornerstone of treatment. Sunscreen can not only provide the required UV protection but may also have the potential to moisturize the skin, repair the disrupted cutaneous barrier, reduce inflammation, and provide camouflage. This is all for today's video. If you find this video useful, please consider subscribing, give us a like, and share with your friends. Thank you so much for watching.